Welcome to today's presentation on the pitfalls to avoid when monitoring applications on virtualized infrastructure. At VMware, we often talk about how our customers prefer to take a pragmatic path to cloud computing and why it requires a new kind of application platform. This talk is about why that new application platform demands a different kind of application monitoring and what pitfalls you need to avoid when monitoring apps on that new platform. So what kind of applications are we talking about? Typically, custom-built web applications written in Java, C#, Ruby, PHP, or some other kind of language that companies use to transact with their customers more efficiently. You use these applications every day to book a hotel room or a flight, to check your bank balance or buy stocks, to file your taxes, and so on. In fact, every sizable business in the world today has custom web applications, and they're critical because when that application's down, the business is down. The first issue we see is companies choosing tools that can only monitor physical infrastructure or virtual infrastructure, but not both. This is an issue because companies do not generally virtualize their infrastructure all at once. You don't magically wake up in the morning to a perfectly virtualized data center. Instead, companies typically virtualize a set of machines maybe 1 month and the next set of machines the next month, and so on. And so, you need a monitoring tool that thrives in this infrastructure that has a mix of both physical and virtual capabilities. If you don't, you end up with different groups using different tools that produce different information that isn't correlated. And no one has a complete view that they need to fix application performance problems and get the business back up and running. The next pitfall you need to avoid is not having total visibility into the entire infrastructure stack that underpins your application. The virtual infrastructure adds another layer between the operating system and other crucial components, such as memory, hard drives, networking, and a few other things, and this extra layer can cause difficulties when trying to track down problems specific to hardware. Often the virtualization can mask what's actually going on. Some tools do a great job of measuring the performance of an ESX host and all the networking devices connect to it, but they have no clue what's happening inside that virtual machine and its guest operating system, let alone the applications on that guest. Other tools will quite happily tell you all about what's happening inside the guest operating system, but have no idea that the guest is running inside a VM, let alone that it's running on top of ESX or on vSphere itself. It's critical to have a single solution that works across the entire virtualization stack, from application down to hypervisor. The reason being, because you can't diagnose application performance problems when you're looking at just half the picture. You need to be able to look at everything, from ESX to application components. You need to check your ESX load, your virtual machine load, and key performance indicators for your application if you're going to diagnose problems quickly and get the business back up and running. Additionally, three more examples of why you need this kind of depth in visibility. If you think of the hassles you'd have if you had to go into multiple tools to maintain your alerting, or try to figure out how you'd manage alert escalation remediation across two or three different tools. Finally, think back to the last time you had to address unplanned downtime under pressure. Did you have to log into an unfamiliar tool to try to figure out why a particular server wasn't working, or mainly correlate performance data from two different monitoring tools in an effort to discover where a problem was? This is easier said than done, because modern web applications can be built using a dizzying range of technologies. What that app code was written in, the app servers, web servers that are used, the database, the messaging, and so on, you need a tool that can monitor a wide range of technologies out of the box and is easily extended to monitor new technologies that might come along. Open source monitoring tools are great in this regard because their existing plugins provide a wide range of code that you can leverage to build your own plugins to monitor new technologies with. The list you're looking at above is a small subset of the coverage that you can get with Hyperic out of the box. There are 85 plugins used to monitor just about anything that you may be running in a modern day production data center. The next pitfall is not benchmarking the impact that virtualization has on your application's performance. All too often, the day a newly virtualized application runs into performance problems, people point the finger at virtualization as the cause of performance issues, and they turn the person who led the virtualization efforts into a scapegoat. What you need to do is measure the performance of your application running on physical infrastructure, as well as how it runs when virtualized. When doing this, you need the key performance indicators for the components that make up your web application, as well as OS level and virtualization level metrics. And you need a tool that you can automatically derive baselines or averages for any of these. Doing this lets you build a shield of performance data that definitively defines how well your custom app runs, whether it's running in a physical environment or virtualized environment. And that is what lets you avoid becoming the virtualization scapegoat. The fourth issue comes from the fact that virtualization can be a double-edged sword. On one hand, virtualization lets you create new instances of your application for developers, for functional testing, for load testing, staging, early adopters, QA, or backwards compatibility testing. But on the other hand, how do you monitor this sprawl of virtual machines? This matters tremendously because for every $1,000 you spend on new servers, you'll spend an additional $3,000 per year managing those servers. That's IDC's number. Paul Moritz has said it was more like $8,000 to manage each 1,000, but let's go with the more conservative number. Now, you might say to yourself, $3,000? No way it can be that much. But it's true. Think about the complex configuration files typical of common open source monitoring tools. This is an actual configuration file from one of those tools, and if you've created one of these for your environment, then you definitely know what I'm talking about. Now take a look. Each of these words is a server host name, and look at the scroll bar. It's a long file. So given this complexity, how are you going to keep this up to date in a virtualized data center, which has VMs constantly starting and stopping, being decommissioned, vMotioning through DRS, or being added? The answer is, you're probably not. Legacy monitoring tools were designed for a previous era of physical infrastructure that rarely changed and was much more static. You need a tool that can automatically detect these changes and update your inventory in near real time. Virtualized data centers have a lot of VMs, and that means a lot of performance information. Collecting all this data is itself a performance problem. For instance, we have customers using Hyperic to collect 1.5 million metrics every minute. That's about 25,000 metrics every single second. It's not hard at all to get to that number of metrics. It's basically 1,500 machines collecting a very typical 1,000 metrics per server. Now, we're not talking about Google scale here. We're talking about a typical Hyperic customer. So you need a tool that is engineered to collect this fire hose of data, to act on it intelligently in terms of real-time alerts and automated server remediation, to resolve common problems, and to present that data in a meaningful way to the admin who needs to rapidly diagnose the cause of performance issues. Not anticipating bursts of user demand on virtual infrastructure is pitfall number 6. Virtualized application infrastructure makes monitoring even harder. In a modern virtualized data center, you'll have VMs constantly starting and stopping, moving around through vMotion, or being added and deleted. Think about the complex configuration files of common legacy monitoring tools. How are you going to keep those configurations up to date in a virtualized data center? The answer is, you're not. Legacy monitoring tools were designed for a previous era of physical infrastructure that rarely changed. You need a tool that can automatically detect these changes and update your inventory in near real time. To make this more concrete, consider the following scenario. The company that we have here is a hotel chain, although similar scenarios apply to any business or organization that has customer-facing applications that experience large surges in demand, including retailers, internet services, financial services, and even government. That company that we're looking at is launching a hotel room promotion. The purchase application that they're using has to work on this day, or the business won't be able to meet its revenue targets. The IT ops team is based on the West Coast. Now, around 8 a.m. Eastern time, buyers start trying to make hotel reservations on the website. Note that this is 5 a.m. Pacific when the admin team is typically asleep or maybe just going to bed. Suppose your virtualized app infrastructure ramps up automatically. In this case, there are many new application server instances to monitor. If you use a legacy monitoring tool, it won't see any of these new instances. Conversely, as usage declines towards the end of the day, your data center will take these instances offline. If you use a legacy monitoring tool that doesn't have virtualization-aware alerting, you'll get a storm of false alerts that will waste others' time and erode credibility. No automated remediation for virtualization infrastructure problems. The airbag is an appropriate analogy because your monitoring system needs to quickly detect common issues and fix them. This is another argument for a monitoring system that can frequently collect metric data, even at scale, as often as once a minute, which an agent architecture enables you to do. You should figure out which key metrics are key indicators of performance problems and have a monitoring system that lets you dial up the collection of those metrics to be more frequent so that you can remediate issues faster. You don't want to be the one that pisses off the entire team because you got them out of bed at 3 a.m. or spoiled their weekend. The photo here is of an actual IT firefight where an operations team is trying to fix a critical production issue that has brought an application down. Note all the people standing around idle who cannot leave because of the seriousness of the situation. There's a lot of wasted productivity here and a lot of ill will being generated. A monitoring system needs to be able to distinguish between a VM that's powered down intentionally and one that's crashed and alert accordingly. DRS does an excellent job of balancing load across available hosts, but the fact remains that you may have workloads on hosts that are not DRS enabled and still need to be able to detect when it's reaching the limits of its capacity, whether due to a specific workload or a misconfiguration. In the movie There Will Be Blood, from a couple years back, there's a scene where Daniel Plainview, played by Daniel Day-Lewis, says, "I drink your milkshake," meaning that his well sucked out all the oil from adjacent land parcels. In a way, VMs running on a common ESX host can sometimes be virtual Daniels, stealing each other's resources, memory, disk, CPU, or bandwidth, in times of scarcity. Do you know the impact of hardware failures on your application's uptime and SLA compliance? Can you manage user and management expectations around application availability when the underlying hardware fails? When you use Hyperic, you can understand which applications are running on which ESX instances. This is made possible by the ESX to operating system to application mapping that we saw earlier. For instance, with application 6, you can see that one instance is on ESX instance B. If the underlying hardware crashes, we still have more instances of app 6 on ESX instance C. Granted, that's not ideal, but 50% of the capacity of application 6 is still just fine. You need to speak to your VI admins and have them include your application monitoring agents into standard VM templates or images used by the application infrastructure. Figure out what their VM revision release cycle is and how you can get your agent on their standard templates. They shouldn't push back, but if they do, mention how greater performance visibility across the virtualized application stack lets you both solve problems faster in a collaborative, drama-free manner, and how automated remediation and preventing false alerts can be a time saver for both of you. When configuring Java to run on virtual machines, there's a few things to keep in mind. For easier monitoring and load balancing, use one JVM process per ESX virtual machine. Use the lower resolution timing Java option supplied by your JVM. Make sure you're pulling out disk information. Check the guest average and disk average latency time columns in the ESX top tools output to ensure that your I/O system is not causing bottlenecks due to disk latencies. And lastly, ensure that you're comparing how overall JVM memory usage compares to overall VM memory usage. So, how do we address all these pitfalls? As you might have guessed, we're going to recommend our tool Hyperic. Hyperic is built to accommodate the reality that companies are running a mix of physical and virtual infrastructure. It's built on the reality that applications are created using a wide range of technologies and that no tool can monitor every technology out of the box. Our industry is simply too innovative. A monitoring tool needs to accommodate that constant change by empowering customers to build their own plugins to meet their specific needs. It's built on the reality that virtualization visionaries, all of you, need benchmarking data to make their case for why they should virtualize application infrastructure. And finally, it's built to free admins from the burdens of trying to keep pace with the constant change that pervades modern virtualized data centers.